Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in again. It's time to make sure that you have your Google Home all completely updated with the latest firmware. I'm going to show you four things today: how to check your firmware on your Google Home, then I'm going to show you how to roll through the settings and get signed up for what's called the preview program that'll get you newer updates than most of the population. From there, I'm going to show you the support page and how they say to make sure that your Google Home is updated. And finally, I'm going to show you a special trick at the end of this video that's going to allow you to move ahead of most of the people in your country, especially if you're not in the United States. So let's get going. Like I said, on the Google Home support page, so this is support.google.com, no matter where you are in the world, this page works and it redirects for your country to the right page. You can see the current preview program firmware version, and then below that you can actually see the current production firmware version. So that's that preview program that I mentioned in the intro. Just keep that in mind. Sometimes those versions are a little ahead of the production firmware version. So you can find this by searching for Google Home firmware on the support.google.com webpage. Now, moving over to the Google Home application on your iPhone or Android device, I'm going to go up top right to the devices. We're going to jump in there and scroll down, hit the three dots next to any one of my devices, and then scroll all the way to the bottom. You're going to see your cast firmware version down there. So that's the version of the device that you have right now. Now, if that number matches what's on the Google Home support page, then you're caught up at least to your country. Now, here's my base Google Home. You can actually see that the firmware version is ahead of what was stated on the Google Home support page. So Canada's best firmware version was 118652. You can see I'm on 124602. Now, there's a specific reason for it, and if you look within this same page, there's something called the preview program. Here it is. You can go ahead and you can tap on that and you can actually turn that on. So let me show you that within my other device here, my other Google Home Mini. I'm going to go ahead and enter the preview program. So I would suggest you do this. They're not really releasing betas. It's not software that's not ready for launch. It's just a preview program. You might find some little issues, but basically within your device here, just tap on where it says preview program off and then say that you want to join the program, and it ties your device to that preview program. It won't immediately update, but if you come back in about a half day, your cast firmware version will be updated to the most recent that you can get in your country and with your current language. Now, like I said, I want to show you on the Google Home support page what Google says in terms of how you complete updates and how you ensure that you're updated as far as you can. Now, what they do say, and this is the way Google Home is intended to work, is this is done automatically as part of setup. So what they're saying actually there is that when you're first setting up your device, you're going to get all the updates you need. That also applies as we go here. You get updates just in the background. Now, one way to tell if your Google Home is updating is there are LED lights on top of the Google Home. I'll show you what they look like with the devices. But if you weren't able to get it updated, here's what they say. Go ahead, reboot Google Home, unplug it from the power source, wait a minute, plug it back in. It should start an update. If the issue persists though, keep in mind you do need to go ahead and do a factory reset. So that's kind of the second level. I'm not going to show you how to do that today, but if you can't get your Google Home all the way updated, that's what you do. Now, here's what Google Home looks like when it's downloading an update. You see those lights on the top of it. They're saying it's from top to bottom, and they're just showing up in white, so that's downloading an update. If it's taking too long, you're going to see six static orange lights on the top of your Google Home. Now, on the Google Home Mini, it looks a lot like it's thinking. when it's downloading an update, and then the error code is essentially two red static lights on the top of your Google Home Mini, and it actually is the exact same on a Google Home Max. Now, something that can stop you from using all of the new functionality or the new features is the Google Home application. You do need to keep that updated. On both an Android and an iPhone, you can set your settings on those devices to keep the Google Home app and all of your apps updated automatically. But if you don't, you're just going into the Google Play App Store, finding the app in My Apps and Games, and just tapping on update there. And it's the same really for an iPhone or iPad. You're just in the App Store instead, go into the updates page, tap update on Google Home's application. So that's how you keep those up to date. Make sure you do that. If they're not showing up needing an update, then you're all the way updated in your country. So now back to the iPhone. We're going to go back in the devices in top right, and I'm going to show you my little trick here. I'm going to scroll down to the very bottom just to show you that firmware version again. Now, you'll notice next to that firmware version, it says English United States. And what I'll tell you is that the US is ahead of everyone else with all the features. And if you choose this, you're going to get access to more than the people in your country. There's more features you're going to be able to use. So if you can handle that, then go ahead and use it. So in the menu, go to more settings, scroll down to your devices, and within here, you're going to find the assistant language. Once you change it on one, you're going to change it for all of them. You can see mine says English United States, even though I'm in Canada. Don't pay any attention to the device address. That's totally fine. It can be in your home country. But the language is extremely important and will give you an updated firmware version, more than likely ahead of your country. And I'm in Canada. And if you look at the very start of this video, the firmware version that I have is not even available in Canada, but I have it because I've chosen this language. So there you go, guys. Hopefully this has got you set up. Hopefully you're able to keep your Google Home updated and get those new features early and often. Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time.